How beautiful is this girl? This is an adult Amazon basin emerald tree boa. She happens to be about 15 years old. And if you're like me, you love all reptiles, but there's just always something about an adult emerald tree boa or a green tree python that they're the most impressive display animals. So if you ever thought about getting one and you weren't sure, maybe is this animal right for you, or where should you get it from, or who should you get it from, and what kind of cage should you put it in? I'm hoping today I can answer a lot of those questions for you. So, hey, look, we're all stuck in quarantine. So if you can give me the next, say, 20 minutes and we can learn about these animals, have some fun, and stay with me. Hi, my name is Gary Scavino. I've been keeping reptiles for almost 40 years at this point. Green tree pythons for 26 years. So yeah, I know, I'm getting pretty old. Hey, listen, I don't claim to be an expert. There are things I continue to learn about these animals on a daily basis. So today's goal with this video is to share a lot of my experiences with you and share some of my knowledge and really give you three key things I think everybody needs to know before considering bringing home a baby green tree python or baby emerald tree boa. Oh my God, I am so sorry to interrupt, but I just caught a glimpse of myself in the monitor. I mean, was anybody gonna tell me how gorgeous I look today? The camera loves me. All right, let's keep shooting. Okay, I think the first thing I wanna discuss is our emerald tree boas or chondros right for me. And by the way, I'm going to refer to them as chondros, and I know they're Morelia now, but chondros is what I'm used to, and I know it's been Morelia, I guess, since about 2013, 2014. But are they right for me? If you're big into handling, I see posts on Facebook all the time, people asking, hey, can I handle them? What's their temperament like? I know even when I place ads, people ask me all the time, hey, what's the temperament like? I think the short answer is that green tree pythons and emerald tree boas are just simply not meant to be handled. I know that might be the unpopular opinion, but I view them more as almost tropical fish, where you could just kind of view them and just admire them for their beauty and kind of leave them alone a little bit. You know, they'll tolerate handling. I see people on Facebook all the time taking pictures with their emeralds and their green tree pythons. So again, I think they will tolerate handling. I don't necessarily think they enjoy it. I think the keeper enjoys it. So again, I'm gonna always revert back to better left alone. I can tell you this one thing, however, when it comes to babies, okay, under no circumstance should a baby emerald tree boa or green tree python ever be handled. Their tail area, they have a prehensile tail. The vertebrae in that tail is extremely sensitive. So if you were ever handling the animal and it just struck at you or whatever, just had a bad maneuver and almost fell, your reaction is to pull back. And if you ever wound up just putting any pressure on that animal, pulling it just out of habit, you are going to do damage, and it's going to be permanent damage. It may not show instantly, but there will be a tail kink, and there will be a depression in that tail. So again, I don't think they're meant to be handled. Babies are never meant to be handled. So if handling is your thing, maybe you have to look at something more like a boa constrictor or a carpet python per se, or a ball python. Those would be better choices. Okay, so the next thing I want to talk about is temperament. I'm going to speak in generalities here. I'm not going to get too specific, but what I can tell you is that in general, green tree pythons and emerald tree boas are not aggressive animals. They may have gotten that reputation from years ago when they were only available as wild caught imported animals, but that is definitely not the case today. I have about 30 or 40 or so emerald tree boas and green tree pythons, and I can tell you anytime during the day I can work my cages. They will not strike. They will not bother me. They're sleeping all day. At night, it is a different story. They are nocturnal animals, and they come alive at night. I'm very careful when I go in their enclosures at night, but I would not call that aggressive. I would call that a strong feeding response. As far as babies, again, if we can go back to that for a second, it goes back to what I talked about with handling. You know, when I place ads and people ask me, hey, can I handle that baby? Or rather, what's the temperament like on that baby? I'm not the right person to ask that question, simply because what people might equate as a bad temperament, I always equate with a strong feeding response. So again, babies are not aggressive. They just have strong feeding responses, but we're not gonna handle them anyway, right? I said we're gonna speak in generalities, but I could tell you this for sure. When it comes to green tree pythons, there are locality types. And again, we'll get into this in videos down the road, but you'll see there's a type of green tree python called a Biak green tree python. They tend to be a little more high strung, tend to be a little bit more aggressive than some of the other available localities. Talking about emerald tree boas, there are two types, right? There are northern emerald tree boas and they're the Amazon basin emerald tree boas. In general, northern emerald tree boas tend to be more aggressive. I'm not saying they are aggressive, but they would be inclined to be more aggressive, more inclined to strike than say over an Amazon basin emerald tree boa. So Emerald and Amazon Basins are just so sweet. I mean, it's ridiculous. They're puppy dog tame. So with that in mind, you know, Emerald tree boas and green tree pythons, they are not aggressive animals. They are not going to come at you. Again, I'm speaking in generalities. There are exceptions to every rule, but I can assure you that you're not going to be attacked by your green tree python or Emerald tree boa. Okay, I may have spoken too soon. Okay, so we've talked about handling and we've talked about temperament. And I think the last thing we need to talk about in this category is, so really, how difficult are green tree pythons and emerald tree boas to keep? Again, short answer is they are not difficult to keep. They're actually probably the lowest maintenance animals you're ever going to have. Problems tend to arise with these animals really after they're mature enough and you start breeding them and cycling them and you're dropping temperatures. And that's really the stress, the added stress from breeding. But as a pet in general, you know, key footnote here is they need to be set up properly. You know, 60% humidity, ballpark in that area. You know, as far as temperatures, we can get into more specifics with this, but, you know, in general, you want to keep your adults, say, 82 to 83 degrees. On the side of northern emeralds, you want to keep them 81 to 82 degrees. So again, proper humidity, proper enclosure, they are far less difficult than most other animals as far as maintenance, and I would absolutely not call them difficult to keep at all. Okay, so at this point, hopefully you've made up your mind that, based on everything you've heard, that you want to move forward and you want to get an emerald tree boa or a green tree python. With that in mind, this is the most important thing I'm going to tell you in this video, and that we're going to talk about is, now, where do you get your animal from? I can't stress this enough. For your very first animal, you have to go to a breeder. Of course, you don't have to go to a breeder, but I can't suggest it enough to go to a breeder. You're going to have so many questions about your first green tree python or emerald tree boa that, you know, you're going to watch YouTube videos and you're going to read, but unfortunately, you're still going to have questions and you're going to require support. And it's going to be such a great feeling to be able to pick up the phone or send an email to a breeder where you just got the animal from. They're going to provide you with that support. More importantly, you're going to get an established animal. It's captive bred and born. It's going to have plenty of meals in it. And these are, you know, we can go into that again. We'll go into maybe picking out babies in later videos. But you're going to get an established baby from an established breeder. You can get pictures of the parents. And when the animal arrives, and believe me, as many of you may or may not know, when you get a baby emerald tree boa or green tree python, it's not uncommon for them not to be feeding when you get them. Yes, even though they're established feeders, sometimes after being shipped, it basically screws with them a little bit. They need to be reset. And sometimes that very first meal, we call it, you know, getting them kicked back in, could be a little bit challenging. And it's going to be so convenient for you to pick up the phone or send an email to a breeder. So again, you just deserve a great first experience with these animals, because if you do not have a great first experience with them, unfortunately, like many people, you won't have another experience with them. You'll just get discouraged and you won't get another green tree python, and you'd really deserve a great first experience with these animals. Okay, so now why don't we talk about where you should not buy your first emerald tree boa from or your first chondro from. Again, I'm going to speak in generalities here, okay, because I want to talk about shows and online vendors. I've been to many, many shows, and I've seen some great chondros and great emeralds from middlemen or brokers or flippers, whatever you want to call them. I've purchased many of those animals over the years, and I've never had a problem. So I don't want to just, you know, cast a general blanket that all vendors, online vendors, and people at shows who buy and broker chondros or emeralds are bad people. It's just not the case. However, in general, I could tell you, and I'm talking again, we're always remember in this video, we're really talking about your first arboreal experience. You're going to need support. And for that reason, I'm going to say, please, at least for your first animal, do not buy it from a show or an online vendor. If you look at Facebook, you're going to constantly see posts all the time saying, I just bought this baby emerald tree boa, or I just bought this baby green tree python, and it's not eating, and I've tried everything. And those posts tend to get lost in the shuffle at this point because they just happen constantly. So I'm really, again, I'm just trying to prevent that from happening to you. You know, there's a lot of things to take into consideration here. You might say to me, yeah, it's just that, but if I buy the animal from a show, first off, they're a lot less expensive, and you get to bring the animal home with you that day, whereas opposed to if you get it from a private breeder, you're going to have to do some research, and you're going to have to make some calls, and there's going to be a waiting list, and I can guarantee you the animal, in most cases, is going to be a lot more expensive from a private breeder than from a show. But there's a reason for that. You know, the best example would be, you know, when I go to a show and I see an adult emerald tree boa, a big northern emerald tree boa, obviously a wild caught import, and they're $400. And then you go online and you're looking for a captive bred and born baby green tree python, a northern, and you see them for $700, $800, $1,000. hours maybe, and it doesn't make any sense to you. But please trust me on this. There's a reason why that big adult northern emerald tree boa is so inexpensive. It's simply, unfortunately, it makes me sad to say it, it's just not going to thrive, and more likely within 6 months it's not going to be around. When it comes to baby green tree pythons or baby northern emeralds at shows, again, it's the key word we're talking about here is support, right? And you're going to need support, your first animal, and you want to prevent from having to go online and making those posts, because good luck getting a hold of that wholesaler that you saw on some show that was, you know, a couple of weeks ago, and good luck getting them to remember you and answer your questions about a snake they probably don't even remember themselves. So again, there are many great vendors at shows selling these animals, and I've personally have purchased many of them, but again, we're talking about your first animal. It's so refreshing when you call up a private breeder that you just bought an animal from that's not feeding, and you could basically just mimic their setup, right? And just get the animal feeding, and as soon as that animal eats for you, it just took a really negative experience and made it a positive experience. Interest to full disclosure also on something else. Please don't think that I'm trying to push you towards private breeders because I'm a private breeder and I'm trying to get you to spend more money. It's just not the case. It's all about having a great first experience so you have a second great experience and a third great experience. When it comes to private breeders, whether it's Amazon Basin Emeralds or Northern Emeralds or Green Tree Pythons, the sad reality is that there are very few animals available from private breeders. When they are available, they sell very quickly, mine inclusive. So when they're around, I mean, you cannot keep up with the demand. So I don't need to push private breeders like myself or my friends on you. That's not the case here. Again, it comes down to saving you heartbreak and saving you money. Okay, so now we're going to talk about the third and final most important thing, or the three most important things that everybody needs to know when they have their new baby green tree python or emerald tree boa. You hear my dog Layla? She's in here with me. She's clicking around a little bit. Hey, babe, she always has to be next to me. So let's talk about rack systems. Think in terms of with baby arboreals, smaller is better. I know we all love the idea of putting in these big, beautiful display cages with live plants, but it's really important to manage the parameters of your enclosure with heat and humidity. So racks do that perfectly. The animals feel secure and they just thrive in racks. So let's talk about babies, okay? Baby green tree pythons. This is my typical baby green tree python rack. Pretty simple setup. I have perches made here by a friend of mine. I'm going to put a link to his site on the bottom of my video. He can make perches for any size cages that you need. That's a little Lyra green tree python in here. So again, in a rack system, temperature in this is approximately 82, 83 degrees. I never miss the animals directly with my babies. What I will do is I'll mist the bottom. I keep these on paper towel. I'll give a couple quick mist in the morning. They'll dry out by the end of the day. This animal will be great in here till about 6 to 8 months old, at which time then I will put it in what I call more of my yearling rack. I have two types of yearling racks. This is the Cambro boxes, and this is a traditional, like the old Rubbermaid, this is a 12-quart box. With baby emeralds, they are a lot larger than baby chondros. Baby chondros in general are in the range of, say, 15 grams in that area. And as you can see, here's a baby emerald. That's quite a bit larger. This is has about, you know, 5 or 6 meals in it, but still much larger than a baby chondro. With the baby emeralds, I keep them in these, again, Cambro boxes. I'd say that's approximately 5 gallons. And again, David Brahms makes all the perches for these enclosures. You tell David what size enclosure you have and he'll make whatever size perch you want. What I love about his perches too, they're each is a different diameter, even on the same perch, you know, thinner to a little bit thicker. And that's really important with these animals too, is you want a nice thin perch. Always go on the side of thinner than thicker. And again, we're gonna go into a lot of these specifics in later videos, but right now I'm just trying to get you set up for when your first animal comes in. The last one I have here, this is a Rubbermaid. And again, either of these is fine. We're gonna keep yearling animals in here, okay? I would say, you know, in the case of emeralds, you could put them in as babies. In the case of green tree pythons, again, I would keep them 6 months and older. Again, David Brahms made these perches for us. It's a little baby green Sanzini, a little Madagascar tree boa that's going to go through an onogenic color change soon that'll turn completely green. As far as substrates, you see that with my baby chondros, I kept paper towel. Baby emeralds, I always keep water. Water is always a substrate with baby emeralds. You could use water or paper towel with baby chondros. I happen to prefer paper towels. As far as heat, that's the other question I always get asked. Where placement do you want? And again, just baby emeralds, you want 81, 82 degrees in that area. As far as racks with heat, people will say to me, Gar, what should I get, belly heat or back heat? doesn't make that big of a difference, honestly. If your room is 70 degrees especially, you know, it doesn't matter which one you get. If your room tends to be a little cooler, I'll usually push people towards the back heat just because the back heat covers more surface area. And again, you always have to have a thermostat hooked up to your cages as well. So I think that's pretty much going to do it. What I wanted to talk about with caging, I'm sure I'm leaving something out, and with perching, but again, smaller is better. I know we all love the idea of larger cages, but for babies, this is what you want. They're going to thrive in these environments and these enclosures. And so let's stick with racks. Hey, so thanks so much for spending some time with me today and for watching my video. I hope you found some of the information helpful. And again, I'm just trying to make sure you have a great first experience with your first arboreal, your green tree python or emerald tree boa. This is my first video. I do plan to make more in the very near future. If you have any specific topics you'd like to see, please feel free to comment down below. I'd also really appreciate if you could like this video and subscribe to my channel. And I plan to have some guests in the future, maybe visit some other collections. Thank you again for watching me, and I hope to see everybody very soon. Who has the best YouTube channel? Me?